one time, bro. It was like the first time, it was the first time I ever used highlight, and it was the first one I ever bought. Cause I bought like the ColourPop and I bought the Juvia's Place one as well, the loose highlight. And I was like, oh, let me try this Juvia's Place one. And I dipped this brush in there and I went whoop. And it looked like someone took a yellow highlighter and drew a line across my face. I was like, I didn't even know what to do. I just wiped it off. Cause I was like, I don't even know how to fix this without making myself look crazy. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Jay. See, I rebranded myself. Today is a slightly different video. As you know, well, maybe you don't know because this may be your first time here, but I mainly do vlogs. Decided to go ahead and to follow a so-and-so makeup tutorial videos. I initially wanted to do that, but the one person's video that I really liked, I couldn't find the makeup palette that she used. Let me not lie. So that I couldn't find it, I just could not spend $65 on a makeup palette because I don't do makeup like that. I kind of put things to it. I don't know how, but I just, like, I'm not good at makeup. Like, I'm not someone who's like a makeup enthusiast or someone who's very good at doing their own makeup. I kind of just piece together what I can and we make it work. But I couldn't justify spending $65 on an eyeshadow palette since I'm not that good yet. Stop recording. My eyebrow looks crazy, I know, but believe in me, please have some faith in me. When I say I'm gonna get this brow together, you wanna have that ombre effect at the front of your brows, cause like you don't want it to be a solid thing. I know my brows look crazy, guys. Please don't slander me yet. Believe in me, have some faith in me. But I'm just gonna go ahead and do the same thing on this other side here. I don't know if y'all heard what my mom said, but and my brows are literally distant relatives. They do not look anything like. I need to move the lighting because my eyebrows look crazy on the camera, but in real life they don't look crazy. Yeah, maybe this is just the delusions of a bad makeup person. My eyebrows still looks crazy, but I think it's about to start raining, but we move.
Took the LA Girl Pro Concealer and highlighted my brown bone in the color Beautiful Bronze. And then I took that onto my whole eyelid and primed my eyelid with that and then set it into place with the Sasha Buttercup setting powder. If you guys want to see that step, I'll link my last video down below because I showed you guys everything that I did. So go watch that video.
Y'all heard what she said. So I actually got, let me first put on, now we're, okay, I just made my life so difficult. So she said she used the LA Pro Girl concealer. The color that I got is the color that I'm gonna use to highlight, but so my face doesn't look like freaking bananas, I'm gonna go ahead and get mix it with my foundation, just a smidge with my foundation, just so the shit makes a little more, you know, a little more sense, a little more dollars. Gonna use, if I keep on disappearing out of the frame, it's because I'm reaching for stuff, it's like all the way on my windowsill. So we're gonna take, when the foundation that I use, this is my absolute favorite, I need to get another one, is the Taint. Am I saying that right? Tint? Oh, I said Taint, I was like a taint, but it's the Lancome Taint Idol Ultra Wear, and I'm in the shade 550 Sweet Sea, and this is like a perfect match for my complexion. So I'm gonna just squeeze a tiny, not even a full pump, you feel me, just a little pump. And then I'm gonna take the concealer, LA Pro Girl concealer, in the shade Toast. I was about to say Toffee Toast. So my camera had stopped recording because I don't have enough space.
Good stuff. All right, so for my transition color, I'm taking Brown's Grip from MAC, and I'm using my Sigma E40 brush, which is a blending, well, no, a tapered blending brush. And I'm gonna take this into my crease.
She said into her crease, Now, step one, identify where my crease is.
And I'm gonna take this basically all over my eyelid. Now, if you guys don't know where to place your transition color because you don't really have a eyelid or a fold or something like that, just look straight and you can kind of see where it's kind of folding, like where the crease is.
Why do I feel like she's, oh, this is, see, this brush looks exactly like the Sigma brush that she's using, because like, it looks like we're using the same brush, but girl, I ain't got Sigma money. But I'm just gonna do what she's doing, which she's just going in here and she's just blue. I can kind of see some. I'm trying to make sure this is blend
this color. Put your transition color and you're just gonna blend it out. Now I'm taking brown down from MAC and I'm using my Sigma E45 small tapered blending brush, and I'm placing brown down right into my crease to deepen it up some before I go in with black. And now I'm just going back in with the E40 and blending brown down out. Now I'm picking up some more of bronze grip and placing it back because it's starting to get a little lost. We don't want that. Now I'm using my Morphe M433 brush and I'm taking Corrupt from Makeup Geek. It's just a matte black eyeshadow.
She's not my black girl, I ain't got black. Yeah.
And I'm gonna take this color right into the outer corner of my eye.
She's talking about outer corner, she got an outer corner, and I'm looking at mine and I'm like, ain't no outer corner me. Okay.
You wanna make sure you pick up a little bit of the eyeshadow and then build your way up, because you don't wanna go in heavy and then not be able to blend anything out. So go and with a little bit of eyeshadow on your brush, tap it off, and then place it into your crease. Now I'm going back in with my Sigma E40 brush. And now I'm taking my MAC mixing medium and I'm gonna lay this on my mobile eyelid so that the color on my mobile eyelid does not tr-
Girl, I was not prepared for this video, but it's some kind of like a, like it looks like something that will be sticky. I'm gonna use the NYX Proof It Waterproof Eyeshadow Primer and I'm gonna try and put it exactly in the same way that she has it on her eyes.
Transfer up here and I'm using my Medium Sweeper E54 brush from Sigma. Basically this mixing medium just stops the eyeshadow from transferring. It stays where I put it basically. And then I'm just gonna let this mixing medium get tacky and then I'm gonna go in with the eyeshadow and the shadows from MAC, which is this beautiful blue color.
I'm going to use, I think, on this palette, it is called, and I'm gonna start with Room for Two, which is the one right here on the top. It was between this one and this one right here, but I think I'll do the top one because it's not too blue.
I'm using my e.l.f. eyeshadow brush to pack this on my eyelid.
So we packing eyeshadow onto the lid, honey.
Now I'm taking a little bit more of that MAC mixing medium and laying it over this eyeshadow. Now I'm taking How Royal from MAC and I'm gonna pack this on my eyelid as well.
Why are you sticking your tongue out like that? Just don't come up in the country with each other, so that's... I'm going to leave that in the video so they can hear how you talk to me. Hey, hey, I'm in it. I'm leaving it in there. Yeah. Y'all heard what she said, right?
I'm gonna do a wing. I'm just gonna keep it on my mobile eyelid and stop at the edge of my eye. I'm gonna start thin towards the inner corner and get thicker towards the outer corner.
So I have quite a few lashes that I can pick from. I have this set, which I've already worn before. By the way, I got these from AliExpress. I'll leave the link to the store that I bought them from in the description bar. I got these as well. I've worn both pairs, that's why they both look raggedy as hell. Here's a little case, and then I have these that I haven't opened yet. Just these, like I have just a bunch of pairs. I'm thinking, I'm not doing anything, so I think I'm gonna try these, this pair, very, very dramatic. But I think I'm gonna wear those.
I don't know, your favorite little boutiques that sell these lashes on IG, they get their lashes for $2 from AliExpress and then sell them to you for $10.
Do what you will with that lounge.
This is the style E82. What I'm about to say is gonna be crazy, and I know you guys are gonna scream from the mountains, but I use bonding glue to glue my lashes onto my face. These are insane. This looks crazy. I look like Big Bird's cousin. I feel like these would definitely work better on someone that has a bigger eye. My eyes, oh my god, no. Girl, that's crazy. Girl, I can't believe myself. Whew, 10 years later. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and try to replicate on the other eye. And we won't see how that goes. So see you in a jiffy. I went in and I did this eye, and I'm doing the last one. Ooh, this is kind of getting in long. See, this is what I was talking about. Don't get the shit in your eyes, sis. Now I'm gonna do my actual face. So now we go to Ella. Her name is Ella Thaii. Let's get back into the studio so she can show us how it goes to contour or whatever.
Now we're going into our highlighting. So I'm using a new MAC Cosmetics concealers in the shade NC50. I'm putting it on the sides of my nose, and then I'm dragging that concealer all the way out underneath my eye, underneath my eyes. You want to make sure that the concealer is in a triangular shape because it really gives you a more realistic appearing highlight.
So, as you saw, she's putting on the concealer. I'm going to be using Toast from LA Pro Girl, and I'm going to put it exactly the way she has it. So, let's go.
Holding your mirror up above your head also makes the underneath the eye more relaxed, so you're less likely to crease and you can really blend out underneath that eye. So make sure you're also pressing your beauty blender, you're not rubbing or swiping. Now when it comes to pressing out your nose highlight, you want to take the tip end of the beauty blender and press that along the bridge of your nose. When doing that, it creates a nice highlighted area, so we know exactly how we're gonna place the contour on the sides. If you rub the concealer around on your face, it's going to move and you're gonna lose that dimension that you're trying to create. So please make sure you're stamping the product and you're not rubbing or swiping.
True match, and it is in the color, I think C10. What color is this? Oh, C9/10, and it's deep. So we're gonna, she's doing the side of her face. So I'm gonna use this brush. I don't know what brush to use, so I just use this because it's kind of thin and it won't do like crazy lines. So she's like going.
So we're just gonna drag that contour down on our face. We're not gonna bring it down too far, and we're gonna be very mindful where we place it. We're gonna place it on our temple. Because wherever you highlight it is where you wanna contour. So if you highlight it underneath your eye, you need to create something here to kind of really define it out. You wanna do it on the other side as well. Now when it comes to the nose, your nose contour should go all the way up to where your eyebrow is. That's how it looks more natural. Like when I see a nose contour that starts here, it drives me crazy. Because the thing is, the bridge of the nose goes all the way up under the eyebrow. This is gonna kind of create a line. The thing is, you want to be very careful even when it comes to how you place your contour down. Reason being, because if you put too much product, remember, you have to blend that product out. So you want to be very mindful with how much you're putting down. So I never bring my nose contour all the way down to the bottom of my nose. I kind of stop it halfway. And then as I blend it out, the product is going to diffuse itself. So same thing. What we're gonna do is, a lot of people, they bring it all the way down here and create that Squidward nose. No, don't do that. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna create a little circle here, or even like a little triangle. I'm gonna start off with blending out our contour. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take that same brush that I used for my foundation, which is the e.l.f. cream brush. Really great brush to blend out any cream product. And I'm just gonna follow that line. What you wanna do is you wanna stamp and you wanna press up. Because the main thing is, this contour right here is basically supporting this highlight. If I'm blending it down this way, there is no middle color here to really create that definition, dimension that we're looking for. So you always want to blend your contour up. You always want to make sure you blend it up. So we're honestly going to press and do it in circular motion. You want to make sure that when you're doing your contour in small circular motions, that you're using your wrist and not your hand. The technique is definitely in the wrist.
Whenever you contour your cheeks, you gotta blend up. You never blend down. If you blend down, you'll make your face appear structured here and you'll give yourself more of a masculine appearance. I learned the hard way. It was embarrassing. When it comes to your forehead, you wanna take that and you wanna blend that back to the hairline. You wanna blend all this back to the hairline. Because the thing is, you kinda want these two things to connect. You want them to meet, you want them to be friends, okay? You don't wanna just have contour blend out here, contour blended out here, and nothing to kind of connect the two. So now what you're gonna do is you're just gonna kind of diffuse that product to where it's like, hey, we're friends now, how you doing?
Girl,
it is like a small dense cream brush, and I use this brush to do my nose contour. Now whenever I do my nose contour, I used to kind of like blend it up and down, and then product would end up being all over my face. What you want to do is you want to take a very dense brush and you want to just stamp it. Everything is a stamping motion, so it's a press and move, not a swipe. We're pressing. And when it comes to blending out the nose contour, you're not gonna blend it out toward this way. You're actually gonna push it in this way. That's reinforcing that line, reinforcing that blend.
the nose appears more structured and defined because. It's time to set everything that we did. I literally take some powder on a damp beauty blender, like semi-damp, not even like super wet. And I literally just press that into my skin. Taking that and like, remember the same technique that I used before. You wanna look up. And I'm getting really close to the sides of the nose because I'm trying to reinforce that contour that I created so the nose appears more snatched. So now we're gonna go and we're gonna contour our face. So I'm actually gonna take Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit and Tan to Deep. So I'm going back in, I'm taking a very fluffy brush, and I'm just gonna blend out my...
Remember that we're blending everything upward to really enhance that highlighted area and give ourselves structure and dimension in our face.
So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a very big fluffy brush. Make sure there's nothing on the brush because I've learned that the hard way too. So with that same contour shade and like, remember like we're kind of like stamping. So we're blending toward, almost on an angle.
Girl, what is this?
Very light-handed, not heavy-handed.
Be very aware of how you blend out your nose contour. Make sure that you're blending it toward the highlighted area to really reinforce that shape.
And I'm bringing that nose contour all the way up underneath the brow. So now that everything is contoured and highlighted and set, there are little additives that we have to go and do. So normally after I highlight and contour, I add a highlighter powder. So I'm actually using a Posmetics highlighter powder in the shade Bel Air.
Okay, so I'm gonna use this ColourPop. It is in the color Super Shock Cheek. And it is this one. So I like using a fan brush because this is something that I'm kind of familiar with doing. So I just usually just dust it on there.
And I'm just gonna basically hit that one up to the high points of my cheek.
Doing this really enforces this entire technique, makes everything way more three-dimensional, gives the skin a beautiful dewy finish, and it just makes everything look more seamless. So I really love using a loose highlighter powder, and I'm putting that on all the high points of my face. So that's the cheek, that's underneath the eyebrow, that's the bridge of the nose, that's the tip of the nose, and even on the chin.
This Morphe lip gloss and it is the color Frosé. The only thing I'm gonna add is this thing that I've seen Aaliyah's face do, but she does it with the white. I'm gonna do it with blue since this look is blue. I've done it before and it's just the little dots. I just need to figure out where I want my dots to go. Using the e.l.f. Matte Magic Mist and Set. And that is the end result of me trying to follow someone else's makeup tutorial. Is this exactly what Shanny did? No. Definitely not. Obviously, I'm not as good as she is. But I try my best and I feel like the more I do it, the better I'll get. I feel like could I have done a little better? Yes, especially with the eyeshadow. It's kind of messed up in the corners. But it was a learning experience. Now I know what to do, what not to do. Overall, I'm really pleased. And even with Ella's video, as far as the contouring goes, I do need to get something, a powder contour for my nose. But overall, I feel like I did a pretty decent job. Let me know what you guys think, any pointers that you can give me so I can get better. Again, all the products will be listed in the description box below. If you enjoyed this, like, comment, subscribe, send to your friends. If you want to laugh at me, still send to your friends. Okay, so my phone cut out again because I have no space. I need to pay for my storage. But let me know what you guys think. Otherwise, thank you so much for tuning in and you enjoy the rest of your weekend.